Alright guys, Kennel Snake is back at you again today. Got two trade packages recently, one from John Gaither and John Wild, my good friends from the Collector's Dungeon crew. We do a live show on my channel. Down below is a playlist that has all of the live shows. You guys can check those out whenever you like. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what I got.
Alright, so I already opened up a John Wild's box. Let's take a look what I first got. There's a little baggie right here. This is the Mego Scramble Cyclist outfit for Action Jackson. Got his pants and also the jacket that comes with it and the boots. I'm just missing now the helmet, and as you can see in front of you is a picture of Amigo Action Jackson wearing this outfit. So thank you very much, Mr. Wild. Next up, got a couple of really cool G.I. Joe figures. First up we have Sergeant Slaughter. He's a Series 5 figure from G.I. Joe. 1985 is when Series 5 came out. I got to actually meet Sergeant Slaughter some time ago and I got his autograph. I don't know where the heck I put the dang signature, but I will have to look it up, find it one day, and you guys can take a look and check it out. But he's a really cool figure. All right, next up is the fridge. That's right. They made a G.I. Joe figure out of Refrigerator Perry. You guys remember him. He was on the Bears many moons ago, and he was a very, very good lineman. He comes with this interesting, I don't know, it was like a football mallet or club. He's from Series 6, that came out in 1987, and I believe he was a mail order figure. But yeah, so there you go, there's the fridge. All right, then we got another really cool figure. All right, so next up we have the man himself. We have Snake Eyes. This is version 4. Came out in Series 10 that was released in 1991 of G.I. Joe, and this is, guys, really cool. I'll have to find his weapon. I appreciate it, man. This is, guys, really, really cool. I'm glad you sent him to me. All right, so next up is Storm Shadow. This is the version 2 that came out in 1988 from Series 7 of G.I. Joe, and he also has his bow. He's in pretty good shape. I'll have to do a proper review one of these days on these guys. I do have some G.I. Joe reviews coming. I want to do the straight arm G.I. Joes that came out, the very, very first release of the Joes, but it says a little wobbly, but maybe I can get in there and take him apart and figure this guy out, get him all fixed. John, dude, I really appreciate that stuff, man. It's really great that you sent that to me. Let's move on to the next thing, which is another, which actually is a box I have not opened yet for Mr. John Gaither. All right, so let's go ahead and crack this sucker open. All right, so first up, I wanna say this, that John Gaither hooked the hell out of me. Hooked the hell out of me? No, he hooked me up. So to start off first with, he gave me the Super 7 Alien, which is, was not expecting that, and I kind of actually really wanted one of these. Next up, he sent me some, holy crap, I know what he sent me, I can't believe it. Holy, well, first of all, he gave me a Adventure People lady, I think this is the ambulance chick, but what's really sick, so he gave me this Mego dude, he's a Chips guy, he's a 3¾-inch Mego figure that was for the Chips line, the good old TV Chips, and yes, his hand is in a very bad position. I'm not sure why they put his hand like that, you know, I'm not sure. And then a couple of minifigures. These are the new minifigures that are made by Super 7. They're MOTU. You have Beast Man and you have Whiplash. Next up is this ball. Looks like the Thing from Marvel's Thing. So there's a peg on the bottom of this figure and you just take the ball and you work it in. I guess am I doing it right? I hope so. Yeah, I'm doing it right, so I'm trying. It's kind of a pain in the ass, but you get the idea. I'll have to get it later on, but that's cool, man. Appreciate it. So next up, he gave me a whole bunch. They're army guys, army men. Looks like some of these are like a jungle type adventure dudes. I don't know. Interesting, but thanks a lot, man. I appreciate that. The next, I've got some Schleich toys, not Schleich. We used to call it Schleich all the time, but it looks like Schleich. I could be wrong. Anybody who's watching this video, comment down below and tell me if it is Schleich or not. That'd be good to know. So really cool. This guy's really awesome. Another guy trying to protect himself. It looks like that's really cool. And again, these figures don't have any articulation at all, nothing. But it's not about the articulation with these figures. It's about the detail that they have. They're really, really highly detailed. Very, very nice. And last up looks like a King, possibly. Yes, it is. This is a really cool figure. He looks awesome. And I'll put it with all my like chatmate type stuff. Looks like his sword probably is broken off. That's okay, I can figure something out or just leave it as is, but he's awesome the way he is. I love it. All right guys, so there you have it. Really awesome stuff that I received from my two good friends, John Gaither and John Wild from the Collector's Dungeon crew. You know, it's always good to have friends, obviously, and it's always good to also be part of a trading circle or trade with people online. It's kind of neat to be in a trading group because you have people in different cities or different states. That's almost like an extension of yourself, if you're a toy collector, that you're almost in different places looking for things. It's a kind of interesting concept to be a part of something like that. But again, guys, I really appreciate both of you guys for sending me all these items. And by the way, I had to go back and look. This guy right here, his name is Wheels Willie. That's right. I'm not sure what the Willie is about, but you know, obviously he likes his wheels. So this guy's name is Wheels Willie from the Chips, Mego Chips toy line. There's a picture in front of you of Wheels Willie in his card. But So anyway, guys, hope you enjoy this video. I hope you guys get to watch Collector's Dungeon that comes out every once in a while, once a week or so. And we'll have more videos coming very soon for you. I will. And also the rest of the guys. Down below is a link to Mr. John Wild and John Gaither, both their YouTube pages. Subscribe to them if you haven't done it yet. All right, guys, have a great day. And don't stop collecting. Bye.